the thing. It's a, you ever heard the saying, the old saying, save the best for last? The old saying, you want to close the doors with the best. And we save the best for last.
Yes.
We're going to get a whole lot of memories, a whole lot of education out of this. Please pay close attention, because it's going to shock you, some of these things you're going to hear. Yeah, we have this caliber of person that's going into this Hall of Fame.
This Hall of Fame.
We're going to start with the opening by Miss Connie. That's Miss Connie.
Hey, Miss Connie.
That's my wife, but she thinks she bossed me around. I just let her.
She knows.
You see, we'll discuss this later. Okay, but she have some important information that she want to share with you that's coming from this last person, Mr. H.J. Spiegel. So I would love for you all to pay close attention to this, because this is who's going into the National Football Honors Hall of Fame, which I'm telling you is only going to be 3 Hall of Fame bigger than us, and we're going to scare the last one. We're not going to be bigger, but we're going to scare the living daylights out of them. Okay? So I'm giving you those 3 names, the NFL, NBA, and MLB. That MLB going to have a problem. But we'll be there. Not going to beat them, but we're going to scare. Okay, hold on.
Hi, I'm Connie, in case you didn't hear that. I have some information about Jay Spiegel. I'm not going to tell you who it's coming from until it's over. The information I have is Jay Spiegel was an outstanding kicker and teammate for the DC Bears. The Bears were known as the best semi-pro football team in the Washington, D.C. metro area during the late 1960s and 1970s. They won 6 championships during this time. And this person says that Jay was our kicker. Jay, as our kicker, helped secure many victories because he was an excellent team field goal kicker under pressure. We used to call him Mr. Clutch because he came through for us on many occasions. Jay made all league twice as the best kicker in the league. And I, as his quarterback, knew I always had an ace in the hole to score if we got stalled attempting to score a touchdown. My experience as a 4-year starter at Norfolk State University and signing as a free agent with the Los Angeles Rams gave me the opportunity to observe numerous kickers, and Jay was in my top 2. As a teammate, he was still great and got along well with his teammates. He's very supportive to this day and still involved. On my 70th birthday, he purchased for me an updated football NFL genuine jersey, number 12, with my name embroidered on it. That's the kind of guy he is, and is very supportive to his community. This is a well-deserved honor for my teammate and friend, from Harvey Broadway Joe Dorsey.
Ladies and gentlemen, I bring to you Mr. H.J. Spiegel. Let's give a great welcome.
Richie told me I could talk for 5 minutes, and I prepared 5 minutes worth of remarks, and so I hope you'll indulge me. My life changed in 1970 when, as a senior at Cleveland Heights High School, also the alma mater of the Kelsey brothers, I decided to write my childhood hero, famous Cleveland Browns Hall of Fame kicker Lou the Toe Groza, and see if he would agree to meet with me to help me improve my place-kicking technique. Much to my surprise, he wrote me back and invited me out to Berea High School on the west side of Cleveland to kick footballs with him and his sons and others. I eagerly accepted the invitation and started a friendship with Lou that endured for 30 years until he passed away in the year 2000. His widow Jackie asked me to sing the Lord's Prayer at his funeral, which I proudly did before an audience of 1,000. Lou had become a second father to me as mine had passed away 8 years earlier. His teaching dramatically improved my kicking technique. My football career at Cornell University was nothing to write home about, although I was good enough to have had a memorable career there. Why it didn't happen for me remains a mystery, as it did for Lou. So after Cornell, with my desire to play still burning in me, after relocating to Northern Virginia to take a job at the U.S. Patent and Trademark Office, I began a 7-year semi-pro career with the Montgomery County Cardinals, the D.C. Bears, and the Metro Buccaneers. The highlight of my half season with the Cardinals was a 37-yard field goal inside Old Lorton Prison with 30 seconds to go to defeat the Prisoners 3-0. My 6.5 seasons with the D.C. Bears garnered me 6 championships and 2 all-league selections. I remember a 50-yard field goal in a championship game and a 43-yarder in a game in Baltimore with the wind chill around 0. I was one of only 2 white guys on the Bears. The other one, Scott Spaulding, passed away last year. Rest in peace, Scotty. My friendships with my Bears teammates endure to this day. I'm happy to represent them here today. My last year of semi-pro football occurred after the Bears ceased to exist, the season playing for the Metro Buccaneers. Most of the players came from the Bears. I appreciate the testimonials from my DC Bears quarterback friend, Harvey Dorsey, and my friend, soccer-style kicking pioneer, Peter Gogolak. 50 years after his retirement from the NFL, Peter remains the all-time leading scorer in New York Giants history. Here's what Peter said, and he sent me a letter that I wanted to share. It's very short. Dear Jay, congratulations for being inducted into the National Football Honors Hall of Fame. Your Ground Zero One kicking tee was a great invention. Being the first soccer-style kicker in college and pro football, I have no doubt that I could have kicked another 10 yards further without the prongs, an honor well-deserved. All the best, Peter Gogolak, Buffalo Bills, 1964-1965, New York Giants, 1966-1974. Peter deserves to be inducted into the Pro Football Hall of Fame for his invention of soccer-style kicking and his jump from the Buffalo Bills to the New York Giants, which provided an impetus for the AFL and the NFL to merge. As an employee of the U.S. Patent and Trademark Office, I was forbidden to be a patentee, so I waited until I departed the agency in 1982 to enter private law practice to begin inventing. My first patent application was filed in 1983, and to date I'm named inventor in 45 U.S. patents. My first inventions were football kicking tees, and 20 of my patents cover the tees I invented. I brought 4 samples with me today, the Ground Zero One, Total, Ground Zero Onside, and Triplex Stealth tees. An early version of the Total tee was first approved by the NFL in 1988, after I visited the NFL headquarters and sold it to famed former referee, Pro Football Hall of Famer Art McNally. In 1996, the Total tee was replaced in the NFL by the Ground Zero One tee, and by 1999, every NFL kicker was using it. That status has endured ever since. The recent NFL season was the 25th consecutive season in which every NFL kickoff was off the Ground Zero One tee. The other tees dominate high school, college, and youth football. It is a rarity when a football game is played and at least one of the teams isn't using one of my tees. It's a unique niche of which I'm quite proud. I want to show you these tees. This is the Ground Zero One tee, which you all have, I'm sure, seen anytime you watch an NFL game. That's the one, you've seen it. This is the Ground Zero Onside tee, and I'll tell you a little secret. Last season I saw one NFL team using this tee, which is not legal in the NFL. I won't name them, and I won't be a snitch, but I did see it on TV this year. I'll skip ahead to the triplex stout tee, which many of you may have seen. It's been used by Georgia, by Navy, Notre Dame, Ohio State, and a lot of the top teams. The best one I ever invented. And this is the total tee, which is a two-piece tee, which was the first tee that was illegal in the NFL. And I had to switch to the ground zero one because this is a two-piece tee and the kicker started pushing up the insert to gain extra height. So that was something that the supervisor of officials didn't like and brought me into the headquarters on Park Avenue in New York and told me I would either have to make a one-piece tee or we would be finished. And so that didn't work out for that tee, but everything else worked out. So 30 years ago, I wondered why all footballs had four panels. I invented a football with five panels and obtained three patents on it. It's better for kicking and passing because you kick the middle of a panel, not a seam, and a quarterback can get their thumb on the second seam past the laces for a better grip. At one point, 600 high schools were using the ball, and a high school in Tennessee won its state championship using it. The patents expired long ago, and I wouldn't be surprised if someone resurrects it. They should. And I want to give this to Richie in appreciation for all his... The success of my tees and others of my inventions resulted in my induction into the Cleveland Heights High School Distinguished Alumni Hall of Fame in 2004. The Kelsey brothers were inducted in 2019, so I'm in a Hall of Fame with the Kelsey brothers. Thank you to the selection committee for accepting me for induction into this Hall of Fame. I proudly accept this induction on behalf of myself, my former teammates, and those who collaborated with me in the manufacture, distribution, and sale of my tees. Special thanks to Richie McFarley for shepherding me through the process, and to fellow inductee and fellow straight-on kicker, Sean Hale. Our kicking technique is virtually extinct now, but it served us well. And finally, thanks to all the attendees who helped make this a memorable occasion. Thank you very much.
Just happened in the last 5 minutes. We done did something that nobody else did. I told you four, we're gonna be number four. We just have an inventor that went into the Hall of Fame in 2004.
Now, the kicking tee.
The kicking tee, he as well invented this football. And so that's it. Need something to kick. Now, I'm gonna say this and we're gonna close this thing out. Let's get to kickers. Okay, let's get to these kickers. If anybody know about the game of football, the highest scoring players on anybody's football team in the NFL, whatever, is the kicker. It's the kicker. And their job is so crazy, they can keep that kicking job. Because you get one shot at everything. You only get one shot. If you miss a field goal, fired. If you miss an extra point, fired. You're not allowed to miss anything. They're not secure. That's one play that's not secure. So if they come on and you have your favorite team out there, and there's 3 seconds left on the clock, and they're on the 30-yard line, and we've been at home eating and begging and lying. We want our team to win, and we call it a chip shot. If he missed that kick on national television, where everybody all over the world is looking at this man, everybody gonna know him. They're gonna be throwing peanuts, popcorn, soda can, everything at him. Everything at him. So you have to understand something about it. I don't want the kicking job. They can keep that. My quarterbacking job, I really didn't want that, but I can make up for that. You know, I can mess up throwing interceptions. I can say I had too much butter on my hand, anything. I can blame it on the center. I can blame it on anybody. I can blame it on the running back fumbled the ball. The center gave me a bad snap. And the kickers don't.